Welcome to glorious Gothenburg. We're here in the Scandinavian Stadium, as you can see on your screens, for the final day of the 2019 Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. The tension has been mounting over 2 days of competition in this extraordinarily beautiful arena. And I am delighted to have alongside me the lady who in 2003 became the first Swedish rider to be on a podium at a Longines FEI World Cup final in Malin Bergard Jonsson. Malin, thank you very much indeed for joining us once again in what can only be described as a very open and extremely exciting competition for this year's World Cup final.
Yeah, today is going to be fantastic. I think we're going to see some great sport today.
Well, that's the trophy. 41 years this year, 15th year in Gothenburg for the final. And looking down the list, we've been trying to work out that if we wanted to, if we were gambling people, who would we have our money on? And everybody has said it is so tight because the performances of so many of the athletes, both human and equine, here in Gothenburg have been exceptional. It's impossible. There's 8 riders with just 1 fence between them. And the seed is set as, and we'll have a look at Santiago Varela's courses later on, because of course this afternoon it's 2 rounds, 2 big Grand Prix rounds. The first round will start in a few minutes' time, then there'll be a 45-minute break, and the top 20 riders from the 25 starters will go forward to round B to decide the champion of the 2019 Jumping World Cup Final. Defending champion BZ Madden from the United States is here, one of 5 representatives of the United States in the top 25 coming forward today on day 4. Marlin, before we have a look at the start list and hear the national anthem, in fact, will be the first thing that we hear. Have you heard, you know, what are the riders saying amongst themselves? I mean, do they feel it's very open as well, that there's a lot of great performances?
It is very open, and the course today is very, very big, so
for sure it's open. Du tysta, du glädjerika sköna, jag hälsar dig värnaste land upp på jord, din sol, din himmel, dina ängder gröna, din sol, din himmel, dina ängder gröna, du tronar på från fornstora dagar, då är att ditt namn flög över jorden. Jag vet att du är och förblir vad du var. Ja, jag vill leva, jag vill dö i Norden. Ja, jag vill leva, jag vill dö. Hanna Boqvist, a beautiful rendition of the Swedish national anthem to get us underway on the third day of competition here in Gothenburg. The tension mounting. I'm looking around this amazing arena, traditionally an ice hockey arena with the ice underneath the surface. Very clever stuff. But hardly a seat left in the Scandinavian arena here. Sweden have never won. Sweden, who have never won a World Cup final. 2 riders that could possibly do this. And this is a great shot of the wonderful facilities here in the Scandinavian. We look at the warm-up area. Marlin, what does that feel like? You're about to go in to one of the biggest competitions in the world.
Yes, there's a lot of tension out there now, and the riders, there's a lot of riders that have done it before, but there's also a few really young ones that have never seen courses like this. So for sure there's a lot of tension. It's a lot of hope and wish to make this a good day for everyone.
Well, let's take a look at the start list. We've got 25 riders. We started with 33 on Thursday, down to 25. The first three riders, Shino Hirota, Kula Kenda, Lisa Williams, first time visits, qualification to get to a World Cup final. E. Jobs from the United States, just 20 years old. Henrik von Eckermann, one of two hopes left for Sweden to take the title for the first time. Ludger Birbaum, 26 years since he won his title in 1993. A defending champion, BZ Madden, with Breitling LS, looking for the double after a victory 12 months ago. And the last five, Martin Fuchs with Clooney. He got a fourth just off the podium in 2017, looking for a podium finish here. Steve Gerdat, world number one, like BZ Madden, looking for his third final. And Eduardo Avera Aznar, on 0 points, comes into the final day in the number one spot. And could he be the first Spanish rider to ever win a Longines FEI jumping World Cup final? The scene is set. Look at those people, Marlin.
It is packed in here. This is one of the best arenas to ride in, and the crowd is so good. They're so with you, and they're so loud, and they are so good because they also know a lot about the sport. So you always get the cheering, even if you're not Swedish. They love a good horse and rider combination.
And there's the man himself, the professor, Santiago Varela, looking a little bit stressed, the course designer.
Looking very stressed, I would say.
The course designer over the last week, and the pressure on these people is incredible. Let's take a look at the course.
Yes, he's set another really nice course, and a really big course today. It should be big. We start off with a Volvo Oxer, 1 meter 50, nice start. You turn right to number two, a white, blue, yellow vertical, four quite long strides down to a black Longines Oxer. Come around and past the in gates to number four. You have six steady strides to the FEI vertical, and then a sharp left turn to another Longines Oxer, a very wide one. Right turn to tall, skinny vertical. And you come on a bend into a double, vertical one stride Oxer, and then to probably the biggest Oxer set on the course, number nine. You then have a little breed to a golden vertical with a water tray behind it, very tall, number 10, and then a five stride to a big Oxer with another water tray on. Left turn to the triple combination, you have Oxer one stride, vertical one stride Oxer, and a five very short strides to the Longines Planks, the last one, 1 meter 60.
First of two rounds, Peder Fredriksson.
Chatting away with his team fellow, Nicolas Philippats, the brother of Olivier. He has a week off this week.
Peder Fredriksson, 18 months ago, brought it home at the European Championships for Sweden. That was about only 500 meters away, the outdoor stadium from where we're sitting here in the Scandinavian this afternoon. Can he make it a memorable double?
I think there's a lot of people in here wishing
sure,
for that.
Including my fellow commentator, I think.
Yes.
Geir Gulliksen for Norway, not in the World Cup this year, but of course, living in Scandinavia, he's here, he's been competing. That's with his son, I think. Is that?
Yeah, that's his son, Johan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And to get us underway for Japan at her first ever Longines FEI jumping World Cup final, Shino Hirota, and Life is Beautiful for Japan. And the support, tremendous contingent for Japanese support here at this wonderful 16-year-old gelding. As you can see, Skubald, and that Shino there, going through the course, I would say, in her mind.
Yeah, she is indeed, and she's she has a little bit of a smile on her face. I think she's quite nervous. It's again a very big course. They've become favourites in this arena, her and her horse. What? She's talking to her horse all the way through, and they've had some really, really nice rounds together. Her husband.
Her husband there praying.
Yes.
he himself, I think, Olympic rider for Japan.
Yes, we competed against each other a lot. Yeah. Fantastic personality.
The final day of the 2019 Longjin FEI Jumping World Cup Final. The 41st year. Shina Hirota. Life is beautiful. A horse that started as a young horse, 3 and 4 year old in Sweden, and unbelievably did a spell of driving before returning back to the very top of this incredible sport.
2, 3, 4. Starts really nice. Oh, a little bit deep there. It's fine. 4, 5, 6 strides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Really good start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Go on. Take some jumping. That's coming out of that double is a big, big oxer. A tall golden vertical, a bit airy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, only just gets that hind mark. It's a wide oxen, you're jumping straight towards the wall, which is difficult. Oh! It's quite an impressive combination you have with the different colors and the gates underneath. It's visual again, and it's a big combination. I just think life is beautiful. Thought that looks wide and big out there. She tries again. Go on. Yeah, she's got an audience with her. Well done. And they're through the finish. Big smile.
Well, what a tremendous start here in Gothenburg. Shina Hirota, her first ever World Cup final. She competes on the fabulous and beautiful Life is Beautiful, completes on 41 penalties. The riders, of course, jumping in reverse order of the 2 days of jumping. The accumulation of penalties over the 2 days. Shina finishes on 41. Well, that's a very pleasing start for all of us here in the arena here.
Yeah, and it's fantastic with the people helping her to jump through that combination. Everybody was on her side.
This man won the Central European Northern Sub-League to get here to the final for Estonia, Kuulo Kenda, with the 14-year-old gelding Artas, like Shina Hirota at his first ever World Cup final. Kuulo Kenda, Artas, Estonia. Bringing forward 22 penalties.
Oops. I was just going to say, I had quite a lot of jumps down on Friday.
Didn't look like a lot of impulsion going in there at all.
No. Let's see if they're all... Yeah. Like if the horse didn't quite know what he wanted to do. Cross-countering through the turn. It's difficult to jump from, yeah. Looks like a horse that doesn't want to have too much pressure, so that's probably what happened on number one. He's going a little bit too steady to it.
Lovely down that line.
Jumps that line really well. Two, three, four, five, six. Adds one extra to that one. 3, 4, 5 strokes. And has the last one. Jump beautiful through the combination.
Kolakenda for Estonia and Artas. They add 22 penalties to the 22 they brought forward, so they finish on 44 penalties. Time allowed round. It's the first of the two rounds they've got to jump today. 73 seconds, quite tight. Now for Saudi Arabia. Another. Now for South Africa. Apologies, it's all so exciting here. Thank you, Marlin, for shaking your head at me.
Looking at you, what are you saying now, Phil?
Now for South Africa. Lisa Williams, another rider at her first ever final with Campbell, brought forward 20 penalties.
Jumped a very good round on Friday with just the two poles down. Three, four, five, six strides. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, a little bit far off, but does it good. So also talking to the horse. Ooh, went down. Looked like it was going to stay
there,
the pole.
Did.
This very tall area vertical now that's not been jumped really well. No, has it?
Great final line, completes on the 29 penalties, just adds the 9 to the 20 brought forward. Lisa Williams, who has been flying the flag for South Africa over the last several months, delighted, competed beautifully at the World Equestrian Games in September, having travelled up to Europe several months before for the quarantine rules. And now here in Gothenburg. That was a lovely last line she jumped there, Marlin.
That was a very good last round. It was a good round overall. You could see that 8B is going to be take some jumping. I'll struggle there. And also number 10, the golden one with a water tray behind it. It's a difficult jump.
Maximum, of course, 1.60 meters, fences at the full height. This man finished on the podium 12 months ago in Paris. He's in 22nd place at the moment. Devin Ryan, United States, and the 12-year-old gelding, Cooper. Rode Eddie Blue to get that second spot behind fellow compatriot BZ Madden 12 months ago. Here on Cooper.
Oops, bit lucky there. Started off in a bit short turn. And a little bit out of rhythm, maybe. Got it now. Oh, jumps that really nice. Five, six strides. One, two, three, four, five, six. Just was not quite with him on those three strides, but managed to do it well anyway. Hold it. Yeah.
At 12. Finishes on 32. Devin Ryan for the United States completes the first of the two rounds this afternoon here on 32 penalties with Cooper. That line 10 and 11 upright over a water tray, then an ox, a similar colour arrangement, in fact, of another one. That looks like, why is that causing such a problem, Mullen?
I think the colour of the poles, they're one colour and they're a little bit blurry, they're nearly the same colour as the ground,
yeah.
The brownish colour. And then also when you have the tray behind, it makes the horse want to jump off a little, take off a little bit too close to the vertical. It's a very tall vertical and airy vertical as well.
Now to the youngest rider in the competition at her first ever Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final, 20-year-old Eve Jobs, with venue to Fees de Hazel. Brings forward 18 penalties after two great days of jumping, and one of the five competitors from the United States, all who have survived to the last day.
Very good. So she chooses the six or seven strides here. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yes. Looking very good. Now to the difficult parts here that caused trouble before. Need to sit up and have a bit of a room to this one. Yes. Three, four, five. Perfect. Are we going to have the first clear round?
This is looking very good indeed, Marlin.
Ah. One, two, three, four, five.
Well, two late falling poles, but a great round from the 20-year-old. A massive occasion for E. Jobs as she adds eight penalties to the 18. Completes round A this afternoon on 26 penalties. 25 starters, 20 go forward to the round B.
Just a touch too deep coming into that triple combination. It just lands on that back bar. A shame, it's a really nice round again.
We stay with the United States. With 17 penalties, Georgina Bloomberg with the 11-year-old gelding, Shamur 137. Second World Cup final.
Had a really good round on Friday. With just the one fence down.
We haven't seen Georgina at a final since 2005. Here at her second final here in Gothenburg.
Gets a bit strong, she gets it back, yeah. The jumping this first pass, really, really nice, all the horses. Six strides there. Easy. Oh.
Couple of seconds inside that 73 seconds time allowed for Georgina Bloomberg. Finishes on 25 penalties with the eight added. So Georgina Bloomberg for the United States, Shamur 137, 25 penalties.
I think it could be a good idea to show the horses this number 10 when you come in the ring.
That's a fabulous remark you just made. That's you're allowed to do that?
You're allowed to walk, of course, or walk past. The same with the triple combination. It's normally quite good to just walk up and show the horses because that's also visually quite difficult. And you can see a couple of them just spooking for a split second.
with 17 penalties from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Khaled Abdulrahman Al Mufti, with his 16-year-old mare, Donna Avita. Finished third in the Arab League. Medley Sabli won a qualifying leg to get here in Al Ain.
You need to watch the number one. They're starting a little bit too slow, a couple of the riders. A little bit too careful on it. It's a wide enough oxer. Got the rhythm now. 6, 7 strides. Really sits up there, jumps it well, and has that one instead.
Ooh. 16 penalties for this round, 33 in total for Khaled Abdulrahman Al Mufti and Donna Avita, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. 33 penalties.
A little bit slow there. Lands on that back bar. Ooh.
One of two Polish riders still in the competition. They started with two, still two on the final day. Wojciech Wojcianiak and Nakord Maloney. 10-year-old stallion by Nabab Derev. 16 penalties brought forward, riding in his first ever Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final. Wojciech Wojcianiak.
Very, very different type of horse to the Donna Avita we just saw. It's a bigger horse, bigger stride. Has a little easier to jump a big oxer than the other one, but just totally different types of horses. Six. Them two very good. A bit of leg. Yep. One, two, three, four. Wow.
What a tremendous round. We've been talking about the two Polish riders. They have been had a most incredible campaign here this weekend in Gothenburg. Just the four to add. So into the lead goes Wojciech Wojcianiak and Nakord Maloney on 20 penalties.
A really, really good round. You can see to the last fence, he really held out to the right to get those five strides and actually jumped it, not totally straight, but it then cleared it beautifully.
And that's the best round we've had so far with just the four to add.
Of course, very happy with his horse this round.
Fellow Polish rider Jarosław Straczynski will be coming later. Kelly Cruciotti for the United States, riding her own 12-year-old mare, Hadja van Horshoff. 15 penalties for Kelly Cruciotti and her first ever World Cup final. Colorado, bronze medal winner at the North American Youth Games a couple of years ago. Kelly Krutiotti, Hadja Van Orschoff.
Really like it how she looks at the next jump before she's jumped the defense before. Oh, bit lucky. Yeah. Yeah. Sit back a little, holding together. Oh, bit quick there. I think you really need to, before that number 10, sit once and make them come back. You've been jumping big boxes. You really need them to jump up again. One, two, three,
this
four,
is another
five.
Fabulous round.
Oh.
The last has come down, but what a great round of jumping from Kelly Cruciotti. At 8 penalties, makes it a total of 23. Two down, 8 penalties. 23 penalties in all after 3 days of jumping for Kelly Cruciotti and Hadja Van Orschoff.
Could have done with just one time sit. Did you see it jumps a little bit too flat over that vertical? Again, you need to tell them a little bit. You need to jump up and not forward.
I can tell exactly what they should do. I'll come back to that. Let's just get Abdul Sayed and I'll tell you what I mean. So for Egypt, Abdul Sayed brings forward 11 penalties with jumpy Van de Hermitage, 10-year-old gelding by Toulon. And here's a horse that looks as if he should be able to jump a course like this. So we're standing here at the Comedy Point at the edge of the Gothenburg Arena. And Marlon Barriard is talking about coming to fence 10 and sitting back. Viewers, ladies and gentlemen, Marlon almost leans back and doubles over as every horse comes to that fence test.
It is a very difficult fence, and you really need to help your horse to try to understand what it is about, because it's hard to see once you're there.
Abdul won the Abu Dhabi leg of the qualifiers, second in Dubai, currently 57th in the Longines FEI World Rankings. We've seen this. This has got an incredible jump, this horse, hasn't it?
It has indeed. You can jump a big jump very easy. Six steady strides, even. Yeah.
Brilliant.
Tries to move a little here for the time because he's quite slow, but I think first of all he wants to jump the jumps clear. Yeah. Jumping really good. It's looking very, very good. Yeah.
Just the one to go for Abdul Sayed. Will we have our first clear?
Yes.
He gets the legs. He's gone clear. He's just half a second inside the time. That is a superb round.
Fantastic
from the man
round.
Who won the Arab League, Abdul Sayed for Egypt. He goes clear. That is absolutely superb.
He rode that brilliant. He did really, really well then. You can see on number 10 that he actually kept the pace, but he was telling his horse he took off really far away from that number 10. Super round. Well done, Abdul.
Abdul Sayed. Jumpy Van de Hermitage remains on 11 penalties, and that's not very far away from those top spots.
No. Now we know it can be done.
We know, you're absolutely right, and this man's in flying form for Germany, former winner of a Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final. That was in 2011. Christian Armand, former world number one, won two legs of the Western European League in Mechelen and Leipzig, brings forward, like Abdul Sayed, 11 penalties into today, the final day, with Clintrexo Z. Christian Armand for Germany, Clintrexo Z. another 10-year-old like Jumpy van der Hermitage.
Oh, a little bit deep there. A bit far off that one. Had three down on Friday, which was quite surprising. I think he wanted to be better than that. I'm sure he wants to have a good finish on this championship here now. Stays out really well there.
Oh. And the last down, so two down, eight penalties to add for the former winner, Christian Amann, for Germany, and Cintrezzo. Finish on 19 penalties.
He was actually the first one to have number three down. That was a little bit, I think it was a little bit too deep on number two and got then a little bit too far off number three.
Well, the temperature's rising here in the Scandinavium. As Christian Amann prepares to leave the arena, this man has come in. One of two riders representing our hosts here in Gothenburg, Henrik von Eckermann with the fabulous 13-year-old mare, Tobex Mary Lou. Brings forward nine penalties. Twice. Podium finishes both on Tobex Mary Lou. 2017 and 18. It's gone quiet. Henrik von Eckermann, Tobex Mary Lou for Sweden.
Yeah. Starts off in a real nice rhythm. He really wants a clear round today. He's been unlucky with a one down in both rounds so far. Which has been very disappointing because he really wanted to be on top by today. 4, 5, 6. Looking really good. Just looks like she runs a little bit deep into that oxer. Oh, bit deep there, go on. Yep, jumps it, beautiful. It up.
Three fences down, jumps the last, but completes with a total of 12 penalties from today's round at the 9, 21 in all. 21 penalties for Henrik von Eckermann, Tobex Mary Lou, and that has almost certainly put them out of contention, putting pressure then on Petter Fredriksson to keep.
Very disappointed, well, Henrik. There. He came in such good shape and with the two fantastic wins before this show, and that was not expected.
Well, we shan't forget their Amsterdam win at one of the qualifying legs to get here in Gothenburg. She was quite staggering. So was Henrik.
Yes.
And this man is constantly staggering. Ludge Birbaum, riding at his 22nd Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final, riding the 16-year-old gelding Casello, bringing forward eight penalties. He rode Casello on day one. He rode Cool Feeling. Yes, on Friday.
And changed back to Casello now. Yeah. Formerly ridden by Swedish rider Douglas Lindelöf. lucky there. He's on 8, so he's within 2 faults from the leaderboard. Oh.
Number 10 came down. That's the 4 to add to Ludger Beerbohm's 8. That puts him on 12 penalties. Ludger Beerbohm for Germany. On 12, just slips down behind Abdul Saeed for Egypt, who remains in the lead at the halfway point here at the first of the 2 massive Grand Prix competitions this afternoon.
Looks here like if he's coming a little bit not straight to it, and Casello is cutting in a little bit and then jumping across that vertical, and then it's really difficult to jump it. Great round otherwise.
So Luca Beerbohm on 12 with Casello. Now for France, Olivier Robert with Tempo de Pabin on 7 penalties. Current leader going into this competition, Eduardo Alvarez-Aznar, he's the one on 0.
Jumped a fantastic round on Friday with just a 1 fault in the jump off. Oh, starts a little bit slow, no problem. Has had 2 front poles of the oxes. Maybe he's pushing a little bit too much for the back bar. So at number 10 as well. Talks to him there.
On the 12. So completes total of 19 penalties. Olivier Robert. Tempo de Pabin, 19 penalties, puts him into 3rd equal place with Christian Allmann of Germany at this stage.
Yeah. Has to ride quite a lot forward for those 4 strides to number 3, and then just has that front rail.
To Austria. 24th in the world rankings, Max Kuhner, riding Chardonnay. 3rd World Cup final for Max Kuhner. With the wonderful Chardonnay and the wonderful family.
Yeah, daughter and wife, nervous, of course.
6 penalties brought forward.
Great shape, jumped beautiful on Friday, ended up 3rd in that Friday class, double clear. Pushes for the 4. Oh, has to stretch a little bit. Very good. Yeah, it settles down a bit in front of this. Oh, easy. Oh, yeah. That looked a bit hairy, like if he didn't know where he was going. We're going to have a second clear round now.
This, if he goes clear, if Mats Kuna jumps this, that's going to put serious pressure on the remaining 10 competitors. Max Kuna and Chardonnay make it clear. They go to the number one spot. There's 10 competitors to come, and this the first of the two competitions this afternoon. But Max Kuna, the wonderful 12-year-old Chardonnay, go clear and stay on the 6 penalties.
Very, very good. Really trying hard, the two of them. Oh. What a round. Fantastic jumping.
What a great combination Max Kuna and Chardonnay make. And this man knows about winning finals. For Germany, also on 6 penalties like Max Kuna, Daniel Deusser, Scuderio 1918, Tobago Z. 6 penalties brought forward. About halfway through, the rest of the riders will be getting ready to come in to this huge arena.
Peter Fredriksson there, catch me not, doing his last preparations.
10 to go. Max Kuna into the lead with 6 penalties with Chardonnay for Austria.
We had great rounds both Thursday and Friday, but with the lucky rail in both rounds. Fantastic little horse, and Daniel, of course, always a very strong rider. Yeah, a bit lucky. Some 10th position. Jumping very good. Come on, Daniel.
Won the final in 2014.
Yeah. Hold, sit up.
He's still clear. Is this a clear for Germany? It is. Well, 2 seconds inside the time. We now have 2 riders on 6 penalties. This is building to be one of the greatest finals we've ever had. Daniel Deusser, former winner of 6 penalties, along with Max Kuna and the wonderful Chardonnay. We still have 9 competitors to come. But pressure now, even at this stage, Marlin, those 2 riders on 6 penalties just builds up that pressure with those other ones to come.
For sure, for sure. 6 penalties is nothing. You see, owner Stefan Konte there, nervous, helping with his legs. What a fantastic round. Lovely little horse.
And that shows you Max Kuna, Daniel Deusser, both on 6, Abdul Tayyid on 11, Ludger Birbaum on 12. 9 competitors to come. Bringing forward 1 less penalty on 5 for Belgium, Francois Matti Jr. with Uno de la Roque.
Lost a shoe there.
Just very quickly, Marlin, on this surface, is that a big deal?
Normally not. It can be disturbing, though. You can lose your balance, and then, of course, it depends on how you lose it. If you just touch the shoe, but you could also cut a little bit of the hoof, and then, but he seems to be perfectly fine here.
Thank you.
And the surface is so soft, so for sure, no difference for the foot. Yeah. bit like that. Go on.
Gets away with a run. Still clear. Plenty of time on the clock.
No.
The last has gone down. Francois Matty Jr., Uno de la Roque. They add four to the five on nine penalties into third place behind Max Kuda and Daniel Deusser. Eight to jump.
Shaking his head there. Very unlucky, had a very good round. See. It's a little deep there. The five strides are really, really short. And he tried to stay out as much as possible, but still got a little bit deep. The warm-up. Peter Fredriksson, catch me not. Looking
this
good.
This man is not knocked the fence down in 2 days of jumping. For Poland, Jarosław Skrzyński with the 10-year-old mare by Chaco Blue, Czaklana. Just one fence off the leader going into the last day. Eduardo Avaria-Azna on zero. Jarosław Skrzyński, four penalties brought forward. Eight to go. All jumping in reverse order from the last 2 days.
Yes, had fantastic rounds so far. Yeah, hole. Ooh, got a little bit quick on that one. Oh, this is getting exciting now. Take a deep breath. Oh. Yeah, now breathe, calm down.
Steady.
Pressure on. Got a shoulder coming in from. Ho ho. Oh. Yes.
This could be a massive moment for Polish show jumping.
Go on. Ah.
Well, the one down, a great round, a great round from Jarosław Skrzyński to Poland and Czaklana.
Very, very good round. It's getting a little bit sharp and coming with the shoulder a little bit in front, a little bit hot coming in there. Just landing on that back bar, coming into the combination.
Jarosław Skrzyński onto eight penalties, moves into third place. Just two penalties behind the two joint leaders, Max Kuna, Daniel Deusser. Seven to jump. The defending champion, victorious 12 months ago with Breitling LS, and she returns to try to retain that title. Beezy Madden for the United States with Breitling LS. The United States of America, and she flew the flag for them in 2013 with Simon, won it last year, bidding to become the fifth rider ever to win three Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Finals. Beezy Madden with Breitling LS. Three penalties brought forward. Defending champion.
Oh, a bit lucky there. Right, got it. It's quiet in here now. Oh, it's gone.
Coming in with Fed Sten down, just on the four faults. She adds that to the three That makes seven. BZ Madden, defending champion, on seven penalties with Breitling LS into third place, just nudging out Jarosław Trzezinski by one penalty. BZ Madden sitting one penalty behind the two leaders, Max Kuhner, Daniel Deusser. Six riders to come. That fence 10, Marlin, that really is playing a part in this competition, isn't it?
It is indeed. It's a very difficult fence to jump. You can see that. It's a shame, she had a very nice round.
One of the very strong team of Belgian riders here in Gothenburg, with three penalties brought forward, like BZ Madden, Niels Brunsins with Deluxe Van TNL. Three penalties brought forward.
Yeah. I think all these remaining feel the pressure. They know if they jump a clear round, they are very close to something really good. Quick around the corner, yeah. Now don't worry about the time too much. She's galloping around there. Oh, sit up now.
So. Fence 10, again, plays a part. Coming in on the fourth vault, pops over that huge plank at the last. But that four ad puts him level in second place with BZ Madden on the seven penalties. So Niels Brunsils, Deluxe Van TNL, add four to the three brought forward. Seven penalties into second place.
Jumping so good all the way around, but just... No, it gets too quick and jumps it too much forward.
20 of the 25 competitors have come. We've only had three clean, completely clean rounds. Abdul Saeed for Egypt, Max Kuhner and Daniel Deusser. Now we go to Switzerland. Also on three penalties, like BZ Madden and Niels Brunsils. Martin Fuchs with Clooney, the lovely 13-year-old gelding by Cornet Ablenski. Three penalties brought forward for Switzerland.
One of them combinations a lot of people have voted for to be on top here today.
Just missed out. Martin Fuchs with Clooney in Omaha a couple of years ago at the final there. Finished fourth.
Touches that one.
Won two of the legs of the Western European League to get the points to be here. You can't just turn up. There's 6 months of qualifying to get to the Longines World Cup final.
Oh, gets a bit strong. Pushes there, good. Yeah. Gets this right now, Martin. Yep.
Clips 10. It stays there. Still yeah. Clear. Now the last line.
Yes.
Very Come good. On, Clooney. Just the
Steady
one to
now.
Go.
Steady.
Plenty
Steady.
Of time on the clock. Pops over the bikes, we have a new leader, Martin Fuchs, Clooney, the beautifully popular combination globally, go clear here in Gothenburg and go into the lead, maintaining their three penalties from the first 2 days. Wow, wow, we have a new leader.
He rode that really, really well. He didn't miss out on anything. Well done.
Marlin Fuchs, ninth in the world rankings. What a combination these two have been.
Fantastic. They're so good together.
Silver medal at the World Equestrian Games. And now into the lead at the Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. For Belgium, also on three penalties. Olivier Philippart, an H&M legend of love. Four left to jump. One on three penalties, that's Olivier Philippart. Then Steve Gerdat, world number one. Then the big hope for our host in Gothenburg, Peter Fredriksen, on one penalty. And then Eduardo Alvarez Aznar on zero. I think that was Eduardo, wasn't I? I couldn't quite see.
Oh, that looked if it was a bit deep there. These two have been great as well. They had a bit of a strange fault on Friday where she somehow misjudged the wall and had more or less the whole wall down. But she's been jumping so good these days. Bit of a tiger. See, she really wants to get on the other side. As soon as he lets her go, she just goes. Oh! Oh my God. What happened there? Oh. That was a very strange mistake.
Well, the eight penalties to add to the three. Slips down the leaderboard, completes on eight. Olivier Philippart, H&M, legend of love, fifth a year ago in Paris. Together now on 11 penalties with one round of competition to come.
Let's see if we can see what happens. Comes in all right. And it's like she doesn't really take off from behind. It's really strange.
The first 2 seconds of takeoff looked okay.
Yes. Yeah, she lifts it, but then she actually can't push off really. Very strange.
And next, the world number one, Steve Gerdat for Switzerland, twice winner of a World Cup final, bidding for a third. Steve Gerdat for Switzerland on Alamo. Two penalties. White armband signifying his position in the Longines FEI world rankings as the number one in the world. Former Olympic champion, twice winner.
Eduardo there.
Of a World Cup final on just two penalties. Current leader, Martin Fuchs. Quiet now.
Yeah.
Final three.
Takes a deep breath, Steve. He's done this so many times, but it's a lot of stress to do it. Yes. 11, one extra stride in there. Jumps it easy. Looking very good. Yes. Ooh, oh, a bit lucky there.
That sounded worse than it was. Oh. It stayed there.
Come on.
The oxer. Oh. Now the planks still clear. The world number one goes clear here in Gothenburg and goes into the lead of the 2019 Longines FBI Jumping World Cup Final. Steve Gerdat Alamo on two penalties, and that's where he stays with one competition, jumping competition to come. Steve Gerdat bidding to join the select group of riders who've won three World Cup finals, throws himself way into contention. We still have two riders to come, but that leaves him on the two penalties.
Fantastic. Happy girlfriend, a happy groom, of course. What a round. Very good, Steve.
So Steve, good at. He is on two penalties. This man brings forward just one for our hosts here in Gothenburg, the European champion, Peter Fredriksson, with Catch Me Not.
Yes.
Showing Steve Gerdat on two, Martin Fuchs, both for Switzerland, on three.
Yeah.
Peter Fredriksson, Catch Me Not, world number six.
Wow. Wow, jumping really, really good. Around there for the time allowed. Oh, this is nerve-wracking. Oh, no. Come on. Get up.
Four on the board. Stays on four, the European champion. That puts Peter Fredriksson on five penalties. That puts him in third place behind Steve Gerdat and Martin Fuchs.
Bummer, I had to say it. I had to. Oh, what a shame. Such a good round.
Peter Fredriksson with Sweden. Catch Me Not. One down. Four to add to the one. Five penalties into third place. Once again, fence 10.
Fence 10.
Being responsible for the defending champion. And many others. Now the man who heads the leaderboard on day three, the final day of the 2019 Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. For Spain, Eduardo Avella Aznar with Rockefeller de Pleville Bois Margaux. Zero penalties, a cool, perhaps nervous-looking Marco Fuster, chef de keep.
Yeah.
Spain, like Sweden, never had a winner of the great World Cup final in its 41st year. Eduardo Avella Aznar. Zero penalties.
Also a great horse rider combination. They've done so many good results.
Sixth in Paris 12 months ago.
Oh. touch there.
Oh, it's gone. Oh. Puts him into third place at the moment. We've got one round of jumping still to come, but that puts Eduardo in third place.
So far, he still has a lot of difficult parts left. Oh.
Oh, that's surely dropped him out of contention. He jumps the last, he adds eight penalties to the zero, which leaves him on eight. A disappointing round for the man who's performed so brilliantly over the last 3 days of this championship. So, Eduardo Avera Aznar, Rockefeller, de Pleville, Bois Mergo, they complete on eight penalties, which puts them...
It's a little bit deep to that tall, very tall skinny vertical. Just and only rubs it.
It puts them, well, there's nine riders above them, but let's just talk about where we are with the leaderboard. Now, let's just, before we do that, let's just say what happens. The arena's cleared and a brand new Grand Prix circuit is put together, but let's look at the leaderboard where it is at the moment. Steve Gerdat bidding to be the fifth rider in history to win three Longines FEI World Cup finals. He's in the lead going into the final round. His teammate, Martin Fuchs on Clooney 51, he's been fourth before a couple of years ago. He wants to be on the podium, preferably in the number one spot, and he's currently on three penalties. And then Peder Fredriksson for Sweden. Peder Fredriksson for Sweden, catch me not, on five. Max Kuhne with Chardonnay on six, along with Germany, Daniel Deusser to Scudero, 1918, to Bargo Z. On seven penalties, BZ Madden, the defending champion with Breitling S. Also on seven for Belgium, Niels Brunsils on seven penalties. And then two on eight. Jarosław Straczynski with Chaklana, along with the rider that we've just seen for Spain, Eduardo Avera Aznar. That is the top riders, the two fences. In fact, six penalty points, not two fences. Steve Gerdat on two, and then the last two I read out there on eight. Marlin, it all starts again with the top 20 in about 40 minutes' time. Steve Gerdat is looking awesome.
He's looking awesome indeed. And again, he's done this before, so he knows how to do it. But I must say, he's not very safe up there because there's a lot of them looking amazing. I think we've had top spot today, and it's, you know, one more round. It's not going to, the jumps are not going to get any smaller. And
they're not.
It's
and now
real exciting.
We've got that graphic back up, and it shows you, for an example, should Steve Gerdat have a fence down? You know, that puts him on six, and that drops him down three places. Obviously, he will be last to jump, so he'll know what the situation is going into his round.
Yeah.
But it's looking very, very close indeed for Steve at the top of the leaderboard. It looks very promising for Steve Gerdat to take his third title. But believe me, one of the most... Welcome back to the edge of an electric arena here in Gothenburg. We're in that building that you can see on your screens now. The question is, which athlete and their horse will the sun shine on in about 45 minutes' time? Who will be the 2019 champion, the Longines FEI Jumping World Cup champion? Well, I'm Phil Gazala, and I've got the absolute privilege of being alongside Marlin Barrière-Johnson to watch the fourth incredible competition over 3 days of jumping, which started last Thursday. Marlin, we just had a quick chat, and you said it's still wide open.
I find it wide open. The horses are jumping fantastic. The riders are doing great. We have, again, a huge track out there, so I think anything can happen still. And it's so tight.
Well, the crowd's filling into the Scandinavian here, the 15th time that we've had the Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final here in Gothenburg in its 41st year. 20 competitors representing 10 nations left in the competition, the final competition. We started with 33 competitors representing 18 nations. Let's have a look at the start list of that top 20. What a moment for the 20-year-old Eve Jobs from the States at her first final in on the final day. The same goes for Kelly Cruciotti, her first one for the US. Poland still with two riders left in. They started with two, they're both in Wojciech Wojcianiek. Ludka Bierbaum slipped down the leaderboard with that one fence mistake in a round earlier this afternoon. Abdul Said for Egypt. Wow, what a clear for him earlier. And the penalties go down to two because the man in the lead at the moment, former champion of two World Cups, world number one, Steve Gerdat on two penalties. But biting at his heels, Martin Fuchs and Clooney just one penalty behind. Daniel Deusser for Germany, also a former winner, on six penalties. And in between those two, the big hope for our hosts here in Gothenburg, Peter Fredriksson, can he become the first Swede to take the top title at a Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final? Well, Marlin, you were the first podium finisher for Sweden when you were third. The wonderful butterfly flip in 2003. What would it mean to Sweden to have another podium finish? Of course, Henrik von Eckermann, who's not coming forward for this last competition this afternoon with the wonderful Tovex Merriu, but you'd like Pedro to win, but he was on the podium. That'll still cause a fuss.
Well, for sure. I mean, this is a hometown. It's Gothenburg. They all want him to be up there, so it would be great if he could stay in the top three and, yeah, even win.
Well, that is the trophy that they are here to battle out for this afternoon. The course designer, Santiago Varela, what a job he has had to do. Marlin, you've been talking to Santiago over a couple of days. It's not easy to build a track for the best riders and horses in the world. In fact, there is Santi.
He's had a great championship. He's so far built so well. He had the 25% coming back for the jump off on Friday. He had his clear rounds now, but it's changed. Every class has changed around a little bit, and I think he's done a beautiful job.
He's talking with a technical delegate there, Guillaume George. He himself from Brazil, a course designer, and of course built at the Rio de Janeiro. Well, it's a big track. Let's take a look at it. Marlin, you've walked it. Tell us what it's like.
Yeah, we start off from the left with quite a big number one. Then we have a slight bend to the left for number two. Eight strides to that Oxer. You come around and then you have already the triple combination. Vertical, two strides, vertical, one stride, Oxer. Then straight away, six strides up to the skinny red and white vertical. Sharp turn back to the left over big Volvo Oxer, six strides to the right, to the very, very big FEI planks, and then a steady six strides to another big Oxer. You keep going to the right for a very, very big triple bar, four strides to a tall vertical, and then the beautiful Longines wall, forward five strides to this double with water trace underneath, Oxer one stride vertical. And then the last jump, the Longines Oxer. It's going to take some jumping, this. It's a very big course. The horses have jumped one big round already. I think this is a hard job for them now.
And do we know the time allowed at the moment?
We know the time allowed, and it's supposed to be 68.
Okay, time will tell whether that is going to be challenging as well as the height of these fences. Warm-up arena at the back there, as the riders just do their final preparations. What a moment for that young lady just in the left of the picture, Eve Jobs.
Christian Armer is wearing this mask because the horse is really scared of meeting other horses. So it helps him stay stable and not see everything that moves around him.
Yes, because it's quite busy in the warm-up arena.
It is quite busy, and some of the horses really don't like the other horses, and they really don't meeting them from the from speed and everything.
There's your teammate for the Olympic Games and the World Equestrian Games.
Next to his fantastic wife, Leeson. That's the best supporter he can have. Writing on his piece of paper. He has to have the paper to remember the course, and he sits with his paper the whole time now, just tries to remember it.
And on five penalties, Peder Fredriksson, the big hope for our hosts. Five penalties. Steve Gerdat, the world number one leader going into this, the final competition on two penalties. Looking around this ice hockey arena, which it normally is, I can hardly see an empty seat. Look at them, right, we can't see on the screens, so apologies for the remark, but looking up into the sky, they're way up at the top here to watch the culmination of the 2019 Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. It's almost feeling a bit subdued here, because the build-up to this, so quite calm before the storm.
Totally, and you could feel this exactly the same amongst the riders before walking the course for this last round. I think we're all just so happy to be in this moment, and it's just the best, the very last round of a big championship, and to be in it, to be enjoying it. I think everybody has the same feeling.
You've ridden at 10 World Cup finals, Marlin. Talking to you and being with you, I feel you're as excited to be part of this, even though you're not riding.
Of course, I would rather have been riding, maybe sure. Being amongst these with not so many falls at the end, but still it's beautiful to watch, and it's, again, it's the sport at its best, the big championship, big rounds, the best rider-horse combinations, and it's fantastic. The best arena with the best people in it. And
the leading four riders, all in the world top 10. Well, we get underway. The final competition that could go to a jump off, looking unlikely, but let's call it for the final competition for the moment. 20 riders forward representing 19 riders, I should say. I do apologize. 19 riders coming forward representing 10 nations. United States, four riders left in the competition to get us underway. The youngest rider in the World Cup final for the United States, Eve Jobs and venue fees de Hazel.
She had had some great rounds so far, been a little bit unlucky. Huh? Kicks there.
Comes into this on 26 penalties.
Two verticals there, 160 tall, both of them. Also, this vertical number four is 1.60 meters. Oh, only just has it behind. Up a little for this big triple bar. Four strides there, very good. And now she has to get the wall because the five strides should be a little bit long here.
Cool.
One, two, three, four. Gets them really good. Beautiful.
That's a very good round indeed. She adds the four to a 26. But for a 20-year-old coming to her first final, Marlin, that's the end of her campaign this weekend. She must be delighted.
She must be delighted. She's had a great championship and so much experience to put on your account.
She puffs out her cheeks. That's over.
Yeah. Yeah. Very nice round. Only just touches it behind here. Not lucky. Very nice round.
These horses jumped in the first competition on Thursday. That was followed up by one on Friday. Day off yesterday. And two rounds and delighted.
Happy.
Big, yep. Smiling. We stay with the United States. The first three riders for the US.
Eddie Mack.
Robert Ridland, also there, Shefty Keith. For the United States, Georgina Bloomberg, riding Chamour 137. 25 penalties brought forward.
Nearly see that coming. It got really short in between the verticals and then they quite get the oxer there. Jumps that well.
Out of the wall, I think.
Yeah. And another two. You can see again, it's a second round today. Big jumps, a lot of jumping. Takes a lot of jumping from the horses. Maybe just running out of a little bit of gas there.
And 41 penalties. Georgina Bloomberg completes the 2019 World Cup final with Chamour.
They're so small, those bricks, and it's so light, so you cannot touch the wall without it falling.
We move to the third of the 19 competitors, the third of the four competitors representing the United States. Kelly Cruciotti with Hadja Van Orshoff. Comes forward with 23 penalties.
Oh, lost the stirrup on the first jump. That's a perfect position with the leg, though. You can't even tell in the jump that she lost it, and she's got it again. Can be crucial to lose a stirrup. Oh. Gets one extra there to that vertical. Bit deep to that one. Oh, she lost the stirrup again. Jumps it well.
And finishes with 12 additional penalties. Oh, 35 penalties for Kelly Cruciotti and Hadja Van Orshoff for the United States.
Losing your stirrup can really cause trouble because it puts you a little bit out of focus trying to get it again.
Now, Marlene, I wanted to wait for three horses and look at the clock, because if the clock were to play a part in this, that's the only situation where you may get a jump off, but it looks like it's not going to. Our first three competitors have all been about 1.5 seconds inside that 68 seconds time allowed. So from the riders coming in at the very end, it's looking very achievable.
It's looking all right, the time. They've been fairly quick horses, and the Americans always move normally in a good rhythm, but still, the time looks fine.
Now move on to the first of two riders for Poland. What a campaign they've had. Wojciech Wojcianiak and Nakord Maloney. 20 penalties. Great round earlier this afternoon with just the one down.
Yeah, number one is quite a big oxer again. It's built quite square, and you come from a little bit of a hidden corner, so you can't really see it until you're there. Spooks a bit there. Yep. And pulls out. I think he's going to go again. Shh. He's coming back. Yeah, finishes off good.
Completes on 41 penalties for Wojciech. And with the 10-year-old Nakua Maloney, just looking at the two Polish riders who've done extremely well here. And we've got.
Sorry, you can see.
Yeah, please do.
You see number one, it just quickly comes up so soon, so the horse is not quite, doesn't quite know where he's going there. Yes.
I say the Polish riders who've done extremely well, both riding 10-year-olds here at this championship, but they're both jumping brilliantly.
They've done great. They must have been one of the better championships ever that Poland has done. And it's not over yet for them.
It certainly isn't. We have Jarosław Kwasinski coming later, but now it's the former winner, the 2011 World Cup champion for Germany, Christian Almann, former world number one with Clintrexo Z, also a 10-year-old. Olympic team bronze medalist, Rio de Janeiro. World champion of 2018.
Takes out one stride in between one and two. Does it in seven instead of eight. Yep. Rode that really well.
Christian Almann, 19 penalties, had an expensive round earlier on this afternoon, adding eight penalties today.
Looking very good this round. Well, it's a bit too flat on that vertical. And a time fault.
Having said all that, a time fault as well.
Exactly.
Just over half a second outside the 68 seconds time allowed for Christian Almann, former winner of a World Cup final with Clintrexo Z, completes on 28 penalties.
Again, the four strides are a little bit long and jump after jumping the tripper bar, so it could be the difficult part that they tend to get a bit flat on that vertical.
And what a great campaign Christian Almann had coming here, winning two of the legs of the Western European League. Second final for this man, Olivier Robert, for France, with Tempo de Pepin, like Christian Almann, comes forward with 19 penalties.
Had three down the first round, which was a little bit surprising. Jumping so good on Friday. Maybe so. Yep. Looking better now. Oh. Yeah, very good. Oh.
That was a super round. One down, one time penalty. Completes his campaign on 24 penalties, Olivier Robert and Tempo de Babin for France. Also a time penalty, as I say, so I might take back what I said earlier about the time playing a part.
That's what I mean. You had the three first American riders, and they come from outdoors, and they always do it light and easy, and the horses are quite fast movers. So Olivier as well, having that number nine, is a very tall vertical, and you're jumping the triple bar, you're making them jump forward, and then they have to come really up for the vertical. So that is a difficult part, that number nine.
Riding at his 22nd Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final, victorious 26 years ago on Razina Z for Germany, Ludger Bierbaum, Casello, 12 penalties.
Oh, that was not going according to plan. There's six strides there, but Ludger just saw the five, and Casello didn't quite. Misunderstanding there.
Four times Olympic gold medalist. Retires. So Ludger Bierbaum for Germany. Retires with Casello.
Here is. They're not wanting to do the same thing, two of them.
Seven of the 20 riders, 19 riders have come forward. Best round so far, the youngest rider in the competition, and Yves Jobs, who jumped this round with just four faults for the United States.
Yes, she had a very good round.
Current leader, Olivier Robert for France on 24 penalties, but they jump in reverse order. A lot of sport to come, because each rider as they come and have less penalties. And there's the defending champion, Beasy Madden.
Looking very calm, walking around.
What a round this next man had earlier this afternoon. Came forward after Friday with 11 penalties, still on 11 penalties. A beautiful clear for Egypt. Abdul Sayed, Jumpy Van de Hermitage. One of five clears earlier on this afternoon in the penultimate competition.
Bit lucky there, ticks that last one as well. Very good. One, two, three, four, five, six. Two, three, four, five. Wow. I think you need to move a little for the time. Yep. Four jumps left. It's looking very good.
10 seconds to get home.
One, two, three.
He's not going to make the time. You're quite right, Marlin.
Yep. Oop.
But he's still clear.
Oh.
But it comes
to no. Just gets a little bit out of rhythm to that last fence and has to really hold him out for the five short strides.
What a fabulous campaign this man has had, the winner of the Arab League of qualifications to get here, 57th in the world rankings at the moment, and what a super, super time he's had with this lovely 10-year-old Jumpy van der Hermitage. 16 faults, his final score for Abdel Saeed for Egypt and Jumpy van der Hermitage.
Shame.
Also on 11 penalties. Let's remind ourselves that the leader coming into this final competition, Steve Godart, world number one on 2 penalties. So 11, that's only just over 2 fences behind the leader. For Belgium, Olivier Philippart, H&M legend of love.
Puts her warrior face on. She has so many expressions, this mare. Taps that one, number one. Yeah, better. Oh, steady. Push. Jumps are very good. Bit deep there. Yes. It's looking good. He should normally be fine with the time because she's a really fast mare. One, two.
Still clear.
One extra stride in there. Oh, I think we might have
just
first
clear. Is this going to be our first clear?
Yes.
Yes, it is. A second inside the time. And that is a brilliant clear from Olivier Philippart, H&M legend of love. Now, Marlin, there's still 10 to jump, jumping in reverse order. But Olivier Philippart on 11 penalties already. The pressure screws are now being put on those leaders, the top 10.
For sure.
Already. He's now started it.
He started it all. Yes. That was such a good round. I think they really deserve that. She's had a couple of strange faults with the wall the other day and also with a B in the double in the first round. She's been jumping so good. What a nice round. They deserve that.
H&M legend alarm, 13-year-old mare. Had some great grades in this competition, still some to come. Two penalties better off than Olivier Philippart coming into this competition. Teammate of Olivier's, Francois Matty Jr. with Uno de la Roque. 9 penalties. 7 penalties. Off the leader, Steve Godart.
Oh, doesn't jump that. Touches a little bit in front and behind. Steady there. And now push. Yep.
Yeah.
the last fence down the first round. He's jumping very good there as well.
Three to go.
Eight five strides. Go home. Get up and
flicks it. Oh, it's gone.
And the last.
And the last. But that was an expensive final two fences because that was looking very good for Belgium. So two down. Accumulates to 17 penalties for Francois Matti Jr. Uno de la Roque. Is into third place. Olivier Philippart with that clear. Staying on 11 penalties in the number one spot.
He gets the five strides a little bit long coming into that ox, and then he gets really short in that double for the vertical.
Now we move in to a whole nother section of this competition, because the next two riders are only six penalties behind the leader. And the first of those two on eight penalties in the arena for Poland, Jarosław Skrzyński, with the 10-year-old mare Czaklana, as her name would suggest, by Czako Blue. Just six penalties behind Steve Gerdat, the leader.
Yeah. A little strong there. Jumps it really well. Oh, runs in a bit deep there. She's getting a little bit strong. She also did that the first round. It's a little bit sharp.
Oh, no. And a superb jump over the last. He's had two fences down, but the man that's 52 in the world rankings, leading Polish rider in the world, what a campaign he's had throughout these championships.
Yeah, they've been fantastic. You can only see she gets a little bit strong and a little bit too hectic in the turn, so he doesn't get it back for that oxer. Here you see she throws her body in a little bit, and then she gets far too deep, and there's no chance to jump. To jump the oxer, but yeah. She's really trying. Again, they've had a fantastic championship.
Jarosław Skrzyński, Czaklana, 10-year-old mare, complete on 17 penalties, 2/10 of a second outside that 68 seconds time allowed. Now we go to Spain. Also on eight penalties, just six behind the leader. The leader coming into today's final two competitions. Currently, as I say, six penalties behind. For Spain, Eduardo Álvarez Aznar and Rockefeller de Pleville Bois Margot. Jumping in his second final. Shot up the world rankings over the last couple of years, in 23rd place at the moment. And this wonderful horse has been responsible for a lot of those points.
Yep. Had that red and white vertical the first round when you were jumping it the other way. Jumps it well now. can hear Eduardo talking to his horse, telling ho-ho. Trying to warn for a big, big plank. It doesn't work. It's better.
And a great round. A tenth of a second inside the time allowed, so just the four to add puts him on 12 penalties. Eduardo Abella Aznar, Rockefeller de Pleville Bois Mago goes into second place behind Olivier Philippartz for Belgium, who's on 11 penalties. We're now down to the final seven competitors in the 2019 Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. And it's the defending champion who's come into the arena as we watch a replay of Eduardo. And now leaving the arena, the crowds welcome the defending champion into the arena. It hasn't gone as well for her this weekend as it did 12 months ago in Paris when BZ Mandan and Breitling LS took the title. On seven penalties for the United States, BZ Mandan, Breitling LS. Clear puts BZ Mandan in front with six to jump. One fence down in the lead, level with Olivier Philippartz.
So far, perfect. A little bit deep. Oh. Very good. It's looking very good. Oh!
Now level in the lead with Olivier Philippartz. One to jump. Clogs the last, but it stays there. So the defending champion adds four penalties to the seven. So BZ Mandan, 11 penalties in total, level with Olivier Philippartz, the defending champion in the number one spot, but there's still six riders to come. And there's quite a gap between 11 and the two of Steve Gerdat, who's currently leader.
A touch far off that triple bar. He just lands with his front feet on top of it.
Breitling, nothing to prove, the winner from 12 months ago. There's the world number one. There's Steve Gerdat in the lead, just the two penalties. Can he win his third title here at the World Cup final in Gothenburg? Now for Belgium. The world number 13 at his first Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final. Niels Brunsils, Deluxe Van TNL.
He's been jumping so well every day. Got caught by that golden water tray in the first round. For the five there, it's a little bit long. Yes, sit up.
The last line.
This
still
looks like
clear.
A clear round.
A clear from this.
Come
man.
On! Oh!
Gonna say we'll put him into the lead, yeah. And that makes. Three on a level penalties. We have three riders at the top of the leaderboard with five to jump here in Gothenburg. Nils Brunsils, the Lux van TNL, complete on 11 penalties. So Nils Brunsils, Beasy Madden, Olivier Philipparts, all on 11 penalties, all in the joint number one position. However, five competitors still to come who have less penalties at the beginning of their round.
It looks like it is only just spooking a little bit on the water tray and looking down instead of looking up for the poles. A shame. You really need to get that line right from the wall down to that double of water trays. It's a long five, so you need to jump the wall going that way so you don't have to push too much.
Five to jump. Three of them amazing greys. And this is the first of those three. Max Kuhner for Austria with Chardonnay.
This is so good. Yes. This is looking very, very good.
Came, yeah. Into the day.
Sit up, sit up. Oh.
Jumped clear earlier this afternoon, still clear now.
Let's hope he gets his line right now.
Four obstacles to jump. Now three. Eight
right,
seconds.
Really well.
Seconds
come on.
To get home. Is this going to be a new leader?
Oh.
Well, it will be a new leader.
No.
Oh, it won't. Well, can one of the favourites coming into this competition has the last two fences down here at the World Cup final puts him into fifth place on 14 penalties for the jump.
Expensive two jumps down. He's jumping so good. He only just touches that coming out. Is it tight? And you have the water tray behind, which is difficult for the horses. And then gets a little bit hectic down to the last one. It is a short five to that last jump. Oh.
But what fantastic sport Chardonnay has given all of us over the last couple of days. There's two, the other two greys. I mentioned there were three grey greys to come. That's the other two, Catch Me Not and Clooney.
Peter with his notes. His piece of paper with its course on.
Winner from 2014, Daniel Deusser for Germany, like Max Kuhner, on six penalties. Guderia, 1980, Tobago Z.
Had a brilliant first round. Beautiful clear round.
World number three.
Such a trier. So much quality. Beautiful. Perfect. This is looking very good. Oh, gets a bit long there. Oh, get up.
Got out.
Yes, ho, ho.
Still clear.
Ho.
One get to up. Jump. He
yes.
jumps the last. That
yes.
is a superb round. From the man who took the title in 2014. He jumps right to the top of the leaderboard, Daniel Deusser, with Tobago Z. Scuderia, 1918, Tobago Z. Six penalties, double clear today.
Fantastic.
What a superb performance. The 11-year-old Tobago Z, what a fantastic performance. We have a new leader, three to jump. Now the pressure has really turned on Peter Fredriksson, Martin Fuchs and Steve Gerdat, because Daniel Deusser's in the clubhouse with just six penalties.
Yes, this is now nerve-wracking. Oh, Stefan Konta, they're helping with his legs. Well done. Right.
Now for Sweden, one penalty ahead of Daniel Deusser, three of Steve Gerdau, the current leader. Peter Fredriksson, catch me not for Sweden.
Wow. Starts off really good again. Oh, steady. Yes. Whoops. Taps a little bit. Gets a good shot there. Oh. Oh, this is getting a bit hairy. Breathe, Peter, breathe. Oh.
Oh, close to the wall, 10 seconds to get home.
Oh, a bit far off there. Oxter, oh, he's jumping so good. Come on, Peter.
He's jumping better and better. Can he get
yes!
there?
Yes!
That's it,
yes!
Peter! That's going to take the roof off this stadium. Hey! Well, Peter Fredriksson, the European champion, Olympic silver medalist, puts in the performance of a lifetime once again. Goes into the lead.
Fantastic. What a round. And the horse is jumping out of his skin. This is so good. The owner, Ebba Bender, then wife, Lisa.
Hey. There are
wow.
This packed stadium. I wish you could see it. The entire crowd are standing. Everybody is going absolutely crazy, but it is not over yet.
Wow. Look
He's
at
in
him.
The lead. Sweden.
Call the cab. He called the cab there. Former event rider, so he knows how to do that.
Yes, how to stick on.
Yeah, shift to keep Henrik Ankerkrona. Oh, bless. That is so good. Oh, the pressure is really on these two last boys now.
And that man, he can take pressure, the number one, but there's also this great combination to come. Current leader then, Peter Fredriksson for Sweden. Five penalties, Martin Fuchs with Clooney on three. Oh. Only a clear will do.
Only a clear, yes. Oh.
Martin Fuchs, Clooney. Jumping to stay on the podium position. Peter Fredriksson, he knows he's on the podium.
Oh. Oh, this is, it's worse to sit up here. This is really nerve-wracking now. Oh. Oh. Oh, get up. So good. Yes. Oh, bit tight there. Yes. Ouch. Got it. Four jumps to go. How is the time? Oh,
seconds, the
bit
time
far
allowed.
Off that one.
10 seconds to get home. Ooh. Flies over the Oxer, jumps the upright, one to jump. Is he going to go into the lead? Is Martin Fuchs? He's
perfect.
Got
what a round.
Perfect round. That is one of the most popular combinations in the sport of jumping.
What
Martin
a round.
And Clooney.
He rode that perfect.
To the lead. They're on the podium. They missed out 2 years ago in Omaha, Nebraska. They finished fourth there, these two. And now he's on the podium. The question is he in second or has he won it? Because there's only one man to jump That was absolutely electric from Martin Fuchs and Clooney.
Fantastic.
Such a popular combination.
Fantastic, and to do that under pressure, this is brilliant. Now this, I'm so amazed by my fellow riders now that perform in this way. It's just fantastic. Martin has a couple of hairy minutes now, waiting for one of his best friends. Oh, that's a focused face.
The world number one, former World Cup champion, former Olympic champion, on two penalties, Steve Gerdat with Animalo. A clear gives him his third title.
He's done it before, we know he can do it, but still, it's a very big track.
One time penalty gives us a jump off.
I don't think he's gonna have that, knowing Steve. He knows how expensive a time for this. Alamo is a fairly quick horse as well, but first of all, he needs to jump them all. Oh, steady. So, talks a little. Oop. Yes, all right. Don't get too excited now. Oh, get up. Oh, it gets a little bit quick. Easy.
Oh, got away with that. Four to go.
Lucky there.
Four obstacles.
Oh.
He won in 2015 and in
16. Steady.
One to go. This is.
He's done it!
He's done it! Gerdat the Great!
He is unbelievable!
Takes his third title of the Longines FBI Jumping World Cup. That man is the most focused athlete you will ever see in a competition. That was absolutely awesome from the world number one. Steve Gerdat.
What a rider, what a horse. Fantastic, what great sport. I spoke to him before he was walking the course and said, I love this moment. This is the best moment I know. And look at him now, I think this is even better.
Well, what a tremendous moment for Steve Gerdat. He's world number one. He's former Olympic champion. He's absolutely brilliant. So focused.
Yeah.
Steve Gerdat takes the 2019 Longines FBI Jumping World Cup final and goes in to this very, very special band of riders to have won three titles. Hugo Seymour for Austria, Rodrigo Pessoa for Brazil, Mark Kassenning and Meredith Michaels-Bierbaum for Germany, and now Steve Gerdat. Gerdat the Great for Switzerland.
Yeah, he shows once again what a great rider is and what he can do under pressure. It's unbelievable. It's also why he deserves that band around his arm. World number one.
Absolutely.
Fantastic.
Marlin, we've got a few moments to reflect on what has been the most awesome 3 days of jumping. Andy Kistler there, chef de keep. Well, I've never seen him smell so wide.
You can't blame him.
Let's just watch some of these moments.
Look at that.
Is this where he rattles the pole? Yes, it is. It gets away with it, but that's all that matters.
Such great sport. There we have it. Final results.
Final results with Steve Gerdat and Alamo for Switzerland. Take the title. Switzerland also take the second slot with Martin Fuchs and the great Clooney.
Peter
Fredriksson on the podium. Well, Sweden, who've been on the podium in third place four times, twice with Henrik von Eckermann, now with Peter Fredriksson, and the first time with my delightful co-commentator, Marlin Bergard-Jonsson. Great for Sweden to have Peter on the front. I know you wanted them to win, but
I think he's very, very happy about this third place. Of course, he's on the podium, and that's what counts on a championship. And it's his very first World Cup final as well. So I think it's a great achievement. And the last round he had, he was also an amazing round. The horse was really trying.
It's Just a couple of things to note. The last four riders in this competition, all in the top 10 in the world rankings, all jumped clear. I mean, there is a reason they're at the top, isn't there?
Yeah, for sure, it's a reason. It's the emotional Steve there. He's really, really happy.
Andy Kisler, he's right there, and John Roach.
No, they really put up good sport, those four riders, and like Daniel Deusser jumps a beautiful clear round today, double clear, ends up fourth. I think he's very happy. He, of course, wanted to be even higher up.
And many congratulations to Martin Fuchs and Clooney, who've got themselves on the podium. They just missed out 2 years ago. Now they're in second spot.
I think we have Peter Fredriksson coming up for an interview.
Oh, let's hear from Peter Fredriksson.
Peter, a podium finish, sorry, and your first World Cup. How does that feel?
It feels great, thank you.
Have you ever jumped in an atmosphere like that before?
It's great here. I think it's one of the best atmospheres in the world.
When you kind of completed your round then and that crowd went wild, what was it like? What was the emotion like?
It was great. It was a great feeling. I was really happy. My horse jumped great and it was a good clear round.
You deserve it. Well done. Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Yeah. Nice pictures from behind the scenes here with Steve. Everybody wants him to congratulate, of course.
Three finals to his name, three different horses. He has this incredible ability to have more than one 1.60 meter horse at a time that can come out and do things like this. He's got Bianca at home.
Exactly. I was just going to say, he left her at home and is still up there. Yeah. So, you know, it just shows again what a great sportsman he is and a fantastic rider to keep doing this time after time.
Let's just look back at some of the other results. The defending champion, BZ Madden, just didn't go her way with the Great Breitling.
She's actually had quite a good week, but one down nearly every round, and it's too expensive. Yeah. It's not good enough, unfortunately. But that's the sport. That's what happens. It's a clear round, the count. Think we have another interview?
I think we've got one other interview. Let's go and see who we've got.
Steve, oh, World Steve. Cup champion yet again. Where does this one rate?
It's amazing. I didn't expect to win. I tried hard and it worked out. It's one was amazing. The second one was amazing, but three is, I don't know what to say.
You seem cool as ice as well. You just seem to handle it all so well out there.
I don't know. I actually really enjoyed this championship. Just being part of it is already a fantastic life experience. And, you know, I try to enjoy the moment and just try to do what I worked for the whole year towards this championship and try and give my best ride in there. And those horses just helping me all the time is an amazing feeling.
Congratulations. Go enjoy.
Thank you so much.
The 2019 Longines FEI World Cup champion, Steve Gerdt. He won here with Corbinium in 2016. And the previous year took the title with Albion's Payel in Las Vegas. Let's hear from Martin Fuchs.
Martin, what an end to an incredible season for you.
Yeah, amazing. Clooney was fantastic the whole championship. A shame we couldn't win, but at least my teammate and friend Steve beat me, so that's okay.
How did that feel, kind of knowing then that it was in the bag for the Swiss team?
Of course, it's nice that at least a Swiss won, but at the end I was fighting for myself. I wanted to win, I wanted to be on top, but Steve was once again better than I was.
And just finally, just what was it like to jump in that arena?
Great atmosphere, amazing arena, great crowd, and very nice course setting.
Well done, mate. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can we just reflect on the Swiss riders who finished first and second? They were both on the podium at the World Equestrian Games. Steve, of course, had Bianca in Tryon. But from your role as a rider, keeping these horses, the husbandry necessary to keep these horses at the top of their form, you know, that doesn't happen by accident.
No, for sure it doesn't. I think, again, with Steve being a fantastic sportsman, and also a fantastic horseman, I spoke to him in Paris and he said he wasn't going to jump Bianca because he really wants Bianca to do the Olympics. year and a half, and you can't do every championship. She's getting a little bit older, and he really wants to have her at her best then.
So, I mean, the Olympics is 1.5 years away, but you're planning that far ahead with the programme for your horses.
Yeah, and especially when they're getting a little bit older, you really need to choose your moments where to, because the championship is heavy for them. And
you only have so many times you can go.
Exactly. And you don't want to push that, because if you start getting injuries, it's hard to get out of you. That's the most important thing we have, is to keep our horses sound. And I think Steve does a great job. And now, if you look at the result, I think he did the right thing.
Sure. And let's reflect on Santiago Varela, the course designer here, for all the competitions that we've had. I mean, he's a very special way that's performed.
I think he's made a fantastic job. It's very, very hard to build tracks over 4 days with these horses and riders. You have to make it really difficult and big without hurting anyone. You have to get that feeling. It has to be jumpable, but you don't want everybody to jump clear rounds because you want the best one to win. But I think he's really made a fantastic job. It's been exciting all the way through, and now I think he can take a deep breath and feel happy.
Let's reflect on one or two of the other performances not in the top three. But Chardonnay for Max Kuhner jumped brilliantly, as did Daniel Deuss's Tobago Z Scuderia, 1918 Tobago Z. You know, another two great rounds. I mean, you know, it's winning and losing at the level of this sport. It's millimeters, it's hundredths of a second. I mean, literally, on the first 2 days, of course, we had 300ths of a second splitting the top two.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
It is unbelievable, but that's the fantastic thing with the championship. When you jump over so many rounds, in the end, you have the best horse-rider combination over the 4 days.
Let's just have a look. Also, there's one I want to just mention: Jarosław Skrzyński. He's been at his third World Cup final. His best performance was 20th, but for him to finish 12th for Poland is very, very good indeed.
It's very, very good indeed. His horse got a little bit sharp today, but he's still, they've been jumping great over the days.
Eduardo Abara Aznar came into today in the lead. It would have been great to have had the first winner from Spain, but it wasn't for me to him.
The first round, he was with the clip wear with zero faults, and he then came in and had a two down. It's hard to say. Wait, I don't know if he was nervous. I don't know what was, but I think
we have a special moment here because of course.
What an incredible day, right? Incredible sport and great ride.
We have the handover of the Longines FEI jumping World Cup flag. The traditional handover.
Maybe I should get another microphone.
Technical problems?
There's a couple of technical problems, but one in reserve.
And there we go. I think that works better, right? Okay, it's been an incredible day, not just today, incredible jumping, but also...
Well, we can see there Thomas Torgerson, event director,
here in
holding the flag.
You are the greatest audience in the world, right?
And the audience here in Gothenburg being congratulated.
Well, there's no question about that, but we
so knowledgeable, so enthusiastic,
and
genuinely, clearly love this sport. Now, the official handover, Thomas Torgerson, returns the flag to Ingmar de Vos, president of the FEI.
To Pat Christensen, president of the Las Vegas events. Where the flag?
Hands over the responsibility to Pat Christensen, president of Las Vegas events. where the flag will be flying in 12 months' time.
This is only a temporary loan.
But of course,
in 2021,
the flag comes
in
back.
The year when Gothenburg, the city we're in, we're in right now, will celebrate its 400th birthday, the finals will be back here.
Oh, Gothenburg crowds just learned that they will have their 16th World Cup final here in 2 years' time.
But for right now, let's give a warm applause for Las Vegas, where the show will be held next year.
So the handover, the official handover of the responsibility for hosting the Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final moves back to Las Vegas. An arena very similar, in fact, smaller than this arena here in Gothenburg, but it's a very similar situation, the arena there in Las Vegas, isn't it?
It's a bit similar. It's, again, a little bit smaller in Vegas, but it's built more or less the same. Thomas and Mack Arena, I think it's called.
Yes, that's right.
Yep.
I think that's. I think they're going back there to the same arena. Well, we, as we wait for the presentation, let's just reflect on the 41 years of this fantastic Jumping World Cup final. We now have five athletes who've won three finals. Hugo Seymour, Rodrigo Pessoa, Marcus Ending, Meredith Marcus-Bierbaum, and Steve Gerdat has just joined that list of accolade riders. Yesterday, we witnessed more history being made here with Isabel Wirth of Germany taking her third consecutive FEI Dressage World Cup final on the Great Vire Gold. That was also a very special moment for the crowds here. Did you get an opportunity, Marlin, to see any of the dressage?
I saw a bit of the dressage. Amazing performances, of course, and Isabel, year after year, just being up there, doing her thing. She's a remarkable sportswoman.
Shortly, the victorious riders with their fabulous partners, their horses, will be coming into the arena. Ingmar de Vos there, president of the FEI. Matthew Baumgartner, they're just saying hello to everybody. Longines Vice President of Marketing, making the presentation on behalf of Longines.
Mrs. Lotte Niebel, the President of the Organising Committee.
Lotte Niebel, President of the Organising Committee, and what a fantastic job Gothenburg have done this year, but they also do it every year. The first final was here in 1979, won by Hugo Seymour with the great Gladstone. Look at the fabulous crowds here in Gothenburg. The appreciation shown by the Swedish crowd is really, really quite something.
And I like this, when they stay for the prize giving, show their support.
I dread to think what would have happened if Petter Fredriksson had repeated what he did at the European Championships 18 months ago, if he had been in the number one spot.
Place would have been down, maybe.
Eduardo Alvarez Aznar, a special thought for him. He came into day three as the leader, but great performance. Belgium, What a super performance from H&M Legend of Love with Olivia Philippart's wonderful mare. The defending champion, Beezy Madden, ended in sixth place with the horse on which she took the title 12 months ago. Niels Bronsils riding at his first final, finishing in fifth. Daniel Deusser has won a title in the past, finishes in fourth place.
And now,
the top three, Marlin.
Did Petey get lost?
I love the crowds in Gothenburg. This is absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, it really is.
We wait for the top three. The podium finishes at the 2019 Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. Fabulous performances from great athletes, both human and equine. The excitement is mounting here in the Scandinavian Arena here in Gothenburg as we wait for the top three. Marlin, they're keeping us in suspense.
Yes.
Did you do this when you were third in 2003?
Again, I know Peter is, you know, sometimes doesn't know where to go, so maybe he's got lost somewhere in Gothenburg. It's happened before. Yeah.
Look, as you quite rightly pointed out, look at the amount of people who've stayed. A vast majority, in fact, I would say probably 90% of the wonderful audience here have stayed for the prize giving. Here they come! Peter Fredriksson, Catch Me Not for Sweden, in third place at the Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final. Martin Fuchs with the fantastic Clooney for Switzerland in second. Steve Gerdat for Switzerland, the man that's now taken three World Cup final titles. Gerdat the Great completes the hat-trick here in Gothenburg.
Well deserved. Fantastic performance. And so nice to see him even emotional there in the interview. It's not very often. It's a special moment for Steve, this.
Steve Gerdat with the 11-year-old gelding Bayucato Alamo. I think Steve is looking, I don't think I've ever seen him look quite so relaxed and happy. This is what it really means to him, what it means to all of you, of course, Marlin, but very special indeed.
Very special. Yeah, the best of feelings to be there, to getting on that podium. That's what it's about.
Great mates, Martin Fuchs and Steve Gerdat.
Yeah.
Both for Switzerland. Sweden's 18 months ago, 500 metres away, he took the title of European champion. Now he's third in the London FAI jumping World Cup final. His first ever World Cup final. Rather unbelievably, Marlon.
Yes, yes. Yeah, fantastic performance. Yeah, listen to the crowd. It was amazing. They love him.
An absolute gentleman. So brilliant for the sport. So brilliant for Sweden. Switzerland. He was fourth 2 years ago, now in second with the great Clooney. A partnership, Marlin, probably similar to you with your great butterfly flip. Those kind of horses don't come along that often, the relationships that you have with them.
No, they don't indeed. And Clooney's it's quite a special horse to ride. I mean, he's had him for a long time now and he's had some amazing rounds, but he also really had to work hard to get him where he is now, and it's amazing. He did so good this weekend. Like you said, of course he would rather have been on top of that podium, but what can you do to someone like Steve?
Champion of the 41st running of the Longines FAI Jumping World Cup champion, the world number one, the former Olympic champion, Steve Gerdat for Switzerland. That makes it three. What a tremendous performance from the man who is so focused, so cool, and so brilliant.
Wow.
Well done, Steve. I just...
Oh. Fantastic.
Amazing, I think you just said. Talking about the crowds.
Yeah.
Just... I think we're both crying now.
Yeah. It makes you proud to be Swede as well.
Yeah, oh, and so you audience. Should be, because yeah. this is unprecedented. Look at this, it's incredible. The national anthem of Switzerland. Marlin, we just saw a very, very emotional moment there with Steve Gerdat. The most fabulous thing for me and for the viewers will be, despite what you all achieve, this all still means so much to you, doesn't it?
Of course it does, and it's so much effort put in here, and it's, he said he was relaxed, but of course you're not totally relaxed going into a final and being in the lead. It's a big effort, so much pressure, and then when you stand there on top of the podium, of course, it's a fantastic feeling.
FEI president and IOC member Ingmar de Vos congratulating the top three and handing over the trophy to Steve Gerdat. And let's not forget Alamo and the great horses, that without them, of course, none of this would be possible. And every rider I've met will tell you they're not the heroes. It's their equine companions are the heroes.
We are nothing without our horses, for sure.
Martin Fuchs, just 28 years old. Uncle Marcus, victorious in 2001 at the World the Finals. And of course, without great sponsors, we wouldn't have them either. So a huge thank you to Longines, as Matteo Berngartner, the Longines Vice President of Marketing, represents Longines here at the finals in Gothenburg to hand over the timepieces to the top three. Well, fabulous crowds here at this fabulous event. The crowds wouldn't be able to be here without the organizing committee. And Lotte Nibel, president of the organizing committee, and what a fantastic job they all do. And so many volunteers, like all these big events, all putting in the time to make it happen. And boy, do Gothenburg know how to make it happen.
It's for sure one of the favorite shows from all the riders as well. We love coming here. And I think also, again, the audience just make it a very special moment to ride in here.
We're fortunate to be able to see what the audience are doing here. They are all still here. It's just so special.
Yeah.
Well, Marlin, as we watch the riders make their way back to their horses in Peder Frederiksen's. In fact, I think their horses are still there. Let's just wait and see, hear the interviews.
You look a bit teary-eyed.
Yes, it's very emotional for me. You all know what this show means to me. You know what the World Cup means to me. So you can imagine what three times winning the final means to me. It's an amazing feeling. Thank you so much.
Well, you came in as number one. You had to be clear. The pressure was on. How were your thoughts in that moment?
Well, you know, you can just try to do your best. It's a sport. There is a big part of luck as well. But, you know, we were ready to give it all out there and, you know, take fence after fence and just try to not make the smallest error and hope that the world would follow me. And you know, it's been amazing through the whole week, and it's, you know, I never expected to win, and it makes it even more special, and there is no better place to win a World Cup final than here in Gothenburg.
The audience loved you here. The audience loved you when you entered the arena. For the people who aren't here, can you describe how the audience and how this arena is cheering for you right now?
Yeah, you know,
At the end of the day, you know, we walk alone every day, but we walk for these kind of moments. And victory, no matter how you get it, it can only be this special when, you know, what I call the heart of the show, the crowd, is there like it is here. And this is for these kind of moments like, that I make this sport and that, you know, me and my team are working hard every day. And I'm so thankful to life to be able to live moments like this. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Steve. And with all the greatest respect, vi har en svensk på pallen. Vi måste ju få höra. Peter, har du sjunkit in?
Ja, det känns helt fantastiskt och att få rida in här och
Do you mind doing a little bit of translation for our viewers?
Otroligt.
Well, he's saying fantastic, amazing.
Det är ni som gör det så fantastiskt I publiken. Det här är den bästa stämningen I världen.
Stort grattis!
They are the best in the world.
Vi är så stolta över dig, Peder. Stort grattis!
And she says we're very proud of him. And of course, we're very, very proud of him.
Time, ladies and gentlemen, for the champagne now.
Well, as we come to the close of yet another historic and great Longines FEI Jumping World Cup final. Marlin, I hope you've enjoyed yourself joining us here.
I have indeed. Thank you so much for having me here. And this was just a fantastic finish. And the words from Steve makes you even more emotional.
I don't think I've... Steve could not have made a better speech. No, it's very sincere. And it just shows you the level of rider at the top of the sport. They are just fantastic people. Marlin, it leaves me to say that it has been a huge honor and privilege to work with you here at these finals. Thank you so much. Your insight has been fantastic.
Thank you, and likewise, Phil. Well, you are the good one in this position. I've been totally safe here.
Well, thank you, Marlin. We hope we do it again sometime. So as we see Steve Gerdat get back on to Alamo, we will bow out of the 2019 Longines FEI Jumping World Cup Final here in Gothenburg. We'll see you in Las Vegas in 12 months' time. But let's just celebrate the man who's joined the elite quartet to make it five athletes that have won three Longines FEI World Cup Finals. And a very special, huge congratulations to the great Alamo, Steve Gerdat Alamo. From me, Phil Gazala, we're bowing out here in Gothenburg. Goodbye, have a great evening.
Goodbye.
And there's your man, Peder Fredriksson, third for Sweden. The three-time World Cup champion, Steve Gerdat, Switzerland, with Alamo!